War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war. War never changes. War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
So handsome.
Not bad. Not bad.
That's my handsome guy.
Thank you. This new haircut's really working for me.
Wait, did you get a haircut yesterday?
Your coffee, 173.5 degrees Fahrenheit, brewed to perfection. And today's newspaper just delivered...
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies. My favorite. More of the same.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean.
But then we're looking at a cold front coming down from Canada, making it crisp and dry for next week's Halloween festival.
I'm so proud of her.
Looking in on next week's forecast, we have a high of 52 on Monday. It also appears our troops stationed overseas are experiencing some unusual weather as well. On the island of Mamba Jiao, the nights are cold. Unseasonably so for Southeast Asia, but for the 5th Infantry, that's as comfortable as an autumn jamboree. All the easier for our mechanized Hellcats to drive any screaming commie memes.
Can you get that? It's probably that salesman. He comes for you every day.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling!
Something that is unquestionably, inescapably American.
Good morning.
Isn't it? Just look at that sky out there. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Then I'm glad you caught up with me.
Oh, me too. You have no idea. Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family's service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information, that's all.
Sure, let's do it.
Splendid! Splendid. Now, let's see. Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Mr. Jeffrey, Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
You heard Codsworth. Go on. How are the two most important men in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that. Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Followed by flashes, blinding flashes. Sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations. We do have coming in. That's confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Oh my God.
We need to get to the vault now.
I've got Sean. Let's go.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant, adult male, adult female. Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
You two, follow me. Come on.
What's going to happen to all those people outside the gate?
We're doing everything we can. Now keep moving. Sir, we need to send you down to the vault. Step on the platform. Step on the platform in the center.
Almost there. We're gonna be okay. I love you. Both of you.
We love you too. Oh my God!
Hold on!
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No, no.
We don't.
Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there.
For you. All new residents.
Just this way, please.
Please proceed in
an orderly fashion. This way, please.
This feels good.
Step over to the table. Take a seat.
You'll need your suits before we can take you further.
Thanks.
Just this way.
What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
See? This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities.
Here you are.
Not that the others aren't great, mind you.
It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
Sir?
My mother and father down in D.C.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
It's a good fit.
Just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
Fashionable as well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
Can you come here?
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In 5, 4, 3.
Has to be a release!
Come on, come on, come on! Oh, God!
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
Malfunction in cryopod manual release override.
God. Why would Vault-Tec do this?
Hello? Anyone?
Malfunction in cryopod manual release override.
Why'd they do this?
Yeah.
giant roaches? What the hell? Here. Where is everyone? Is this all that's left? Nice. Coming back later for you. Don't think I can pick this.
Thank you.
and thank you for choosing Vault Tech.
As I live and breathe. Oh, it's really you.
Codsworth. What happened to the world?
The world, sir? Well, besides our geranium still being the envy of Sanctuary Hills, I'm afraid things have been dreadfully dull around here.
Things will be so much more exciting with you and Mrs. back. Where is your better half, by the by?
They came into the vault. Maybe you saw them, armed, wearing strange outfits.
Only Miss Rose's boy running around in his Halloween costume more than a week early. I swear, the nerve of that woman leaving her brat unsupervised. Ha ha, not like this family, sir. You and the missus have always been such a responsible couple. Where is she, by the by?
She's in a better place.
Sir, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
Sean's been kidnapped. But I'm going to find him. I'm going to get my son back.
It's worse than I thought. Mm-hmm. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
200 years? What? Are you...
A bit over 210, actually, sir. Or give or take a little. For the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack? You must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little weird.
What's wrong?
Oh, sir, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing! And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car! The car! How do you polish rust?
Stay with me, pal. Focus.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, sir. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. I did find this holotape. I believe the missus was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, everything happened.
Thank you, Codsworth.
You're welcome. Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? The missus and young Sean may turn up yet.
All right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, sir! Picking up hostile life, found you!
Thanks for trying, Codsworth.
You can't give up, sir. What about the city? Concord is nearby, and, well, the people there have only shot at me a few times.
Thanks for your help, Codsworth.
Good luck, sir. You'll find young Sean. I know you will. I shall remain here and secure the home front.
Sweet.
There we go. There we go. Thank you.
Locke's really strong.